18 may seem like a long ways away, but congressional candidates are already lining up and raising money. Once again, one of the nation's most closely watched races is expected to be in the Minnesota 3rd Congressional District. Congressman Eric Paulson has represented the district since 2009. He easily won re-election in 2016 by double digits, but since then has been the target of protests for not holding in-person town hall meetings. He has already attracted one very high-profile Democrat who is already campaigning hard. Dean Phillips is an heir to the Phillips liquor fortune, a prominent businessman in his own right, and a well-known philanthropist. And Dean Phillips joins us now. Thank you so much for coming on.
It's great to be here. Thank
you. And I know that there are other Democrats throwing their hat in the ring, but I was at the Edina parade covering it. You had a lot of people. You obviously are working very hard. You've been working hard all week. Why are you so invested in this race already?
You know, I consider it to be a responsibility. I share the concerns of a district that is gravely concerned about the competency and character of our president, concerned about a Congress that lacks the courage, especially members of his own party, to speak truth to power, concerns in the district about how money in politics is corrupting and really causing immense problems that, in my estimation, are the roots of why Congress is so dysfunctional. But I'll tell you, I'm doing this more out of a spirit of hopefulness and optimism, which I see every day as I go through the district in my 1960 International Harvester Metro van. And I find this to be a joyful pursuit, a responsibility to participate. And I've been blessed with good fortune and simply want to provide opportunity to as many to people as I can in our district and in our country.
Well, let's talk about your background, because I think obviously people recognize your name. They recognize, you know, the philanthropy that you've been involved in, your success as a businessman in your own right. Your story is not quite as simple as it might seem. Obviously, you grew up in the Phillips liquor family, but it was by luck.
It was by luck. My birth father, Artie Peffer, was killed in the Vietnam War when I was 6 months old, and my mother was 24 years old and widowed, and we moved in with my great-grandparents in St. Paul. Artie, my father, had gone to the University of Minnesota on an ROTC scholarship because he lacked the resources to attend school. So I recognize what government can provide and what government can take away, and also that very fine line between advantage and disadvantage, and I consider it my responsibility to afford that to others.
All right. Let's talk about Congressman Paulson. He won by more than 10 percentage points in a district that Hillary Clinton won by just about 10 percentage points. Does that suggest to you that perhaps you have an opening here? Congressman Paulson's been very successful in running for re-election.
He has, and I recognize that. And I don't disparage his character. I disparage his misrepresentation, certainly. That troubles me. And a Democrat has not won.
And what do you mean by misrepresentation?
Well, you know, I believe he misrepresents his record. I do believe Eric Paulson went to Washington as a moderate. I think over his 5 terms, that has changed considerably. He votes 100% of the time with President Trump's agenda and has migrated very far right, including his vote on the AHCA, the recent health care legislation, 2 times in the Ways and Means Committee and on the House floor. But yet he represents himself as a moderate, and this district indeed is. Voted for Obama 2 times, for Hillary Clinton by 10 points, for Senator Klobuchar by double digits and more. And it's a beautiful swing district in that respect, one of the very last in this country.
Well, it hasn't been swinging.
Well, it hasn't been swinging in this seat.
You know, in terms of this seat. But let's talk. You mentioned Senator Klobuchar. I know that Congressman Paulson has made it a point to work with Senator Klobuchar on some important legislation, specifically sex trafficking, really long before a lot of other people were talking about it. Your thoughts about that, because he has made an effort to have some bipartisan bills under his belt.
Yeah, and I respect that. I do not demean character in that respect. That's an example of some bipartisan work that I do salute. However, most of the recent votes are extremely right as the agenda has moved that way. And there's more to it than just doing some bipartisan work, because the fundamental responsibility of representation is showing up. And he is not doing that terribly well, in my estimation. Hasn't held a town hall in many years.
He will argue, and in terms of, you know, since the election, I do not believe there's been any in person. He says he has held telephone town halls. Mm-hmm. And in the past year, if you go back before the election, he has held some. I'm not aware of any personally in person after the 2016 November election.
And in my estimation, that's misleading. I believe representation, means showing up in person. And frankly, no matter who wins an election these days, in most cases, about half of a district does not vote for the eventual representative. And we have to all recognize that. And showing up means listening to those who disagree with you. In fact, one of the great the joys of this pursuit is speaking with people who may not agree with me on the surface. But when you afford the opportunity to have conversation and talk, it's amazing what you can learn. And I believe, and this is true of both parties, I'm disappointed in both parties in the respect that so partisan and so only willing to really listen to those who already agree with you. We have to do better by listening to others.
Well, Dean Phillips, thank you so much. One of the candidates running in the 3rd Congressional District.
Thank you,
Ezra. Appreciate it.